Hello children, welcome again for the new session of science chapter 5 acids, bases and salt. In the previous video you have learned about properties and uses of acid and properties of bases. Today we are going to learn uses of bases and properties and uses of salt. Okay children, let's begin. Children, today's session let us begin with uses of bases. Generally, today we are going to learn about three bases: calcium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide and ammonium hydroxide. First one, calcium hydroxide. What are the uses of calcium hydroxide? Number one, for whitewashing of building. You can see the picture on the screen. This calcium hydroxide used for whitewashing of building. Second, uses manufacture bleaching powder. Number three, it is added to the soil to neutralize the acid present in it. You are knowing that we are already learned about the previous videos. Soil contain too much of acid. To neutralize this acid, we are adding calcium hydroxide to the soil to neutralize the acid present in it. And next one, the factory waste. That also you have already learned that this factory waste are treated with calcium hydroxide for what? To neutralize the acid before the wastewater is disposing. Understand? So these are the main four uses of calcium hydroxide: for whitewashing, for the manufacture of bleaching powder, and it is added to the soil to neutralize the acid content. And again, the factory waste are treated with calcium hydroxide to neutralize the acid content before disposing into the water bodies. These are the uses of calcium hydroxide. Okay. Second base, sodium hydroxide. What are the uses of sodium hydroxide? I have written here mainly two uses: to manufacture soap. Second one, to manufacture paper, rayon, different types of medicine, etc. Okay children, now the third base is ammonium hydroxide. Let us see what are the uses of ammonium hydroxide. Number one, to manufacture fertilizers such as ammonium nitrate. This is a chemical fertilizer. Ammonium hydroxide is used for making many chemical fertilizers, and one of this chemical fertilizer is ammonium nitrate. Okay. And second use, as ink remover. This ammonium hydroxide is using as an ink remover to remove ink spot from cloth. So this using as an ink remover, so that it is using to remove ink spot from the clothes. Oh, last use, to manufacture nylon, plastic, dyes, etc. Okay, these are the uses of ammonium hydroxide. Now we have already learned the uses of bases like sodium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, ammonium hydroxide. Okay. Children, now we have already learned about properties and uses of acids and bases. Now next we are going to learn about the properties and uses of salt. First of all, let us learn about properties of salt. Okay, first point, most salts are solid with high melting and boiling point. The salts are having high melting and boiling point. Second point, most salts are soluble in water. That we are already knowing that salt is soluble in water. Next one, salt solution in water as a good conductor of electricity. Salt solution is a good conductor of electricity. It allows to pass electricity. Okay, now let us see the uses of salt. First salt, sodium chloride. That sodium chloride that we are using in our house, what is the use of that? In food, as a preservative in pickles. You know that when we are preparing the pickles in our house, we are using the sodium chloride for the preservation. That only you have seen on the screen. Next one, manufacture of washing soda, baking soda, etc. For the manufacturing process of washing soda and baking soda, we are using sodium chloride. Okay, this is the use, these are the uses of sodium chloride. Now we are learning about uses of salt. First one, we already learned sodium chloride we are using in our houses for the preservation of food items. Second one, potash alum. This potash alum is mainly used in the purification of water. See the picture on the screen, that white color, that is known as potash alum. And next one is copper sulfate. The other name of copper sulfate is blue vitriol. You can see on the screen the blue color, that is a copper sulfate. What is the use of that? It is used as a fungicide and in electroplating. The next one is the sodium bicarbonate. Sodium bicarbonate is used in baking breads and cakes. In the generally they are using in the bakeries and all, for the baking of breads and cake they are using sodium bicarbonate. Another use is, it is used in medicines as well as fire extinguisher. Fire extinguisher also, to put off the fire, in for making that fire extinguisher, sodium bicarbonate is using. Okay children, these are the uses of salt. Four main types of salt we have learned now: sodium chloride, potash alum, copper sulfate and sodium bicarbonate. Okay, we are winding up the session now. Tomorrow means next video I will come with another topic. Till then, take care, keep learning. Thank you.